The search for Planet 9 has recently taken an interesting turn in that we now have evidence of a candidate, the best one so far. Or maybe not, more on that in a bit. Though it is a good candidate for something. In 2016, Mike Brown and Konstantin Bitigin proposed that unusual groups of the orbits of some objects in the Kuiper Belt could be explained by the existence of a large, undiscovered planet lurking in the outer solar system. This planet would have to be more massive than Earth to account for the observed gravitational effects on the outer solar system, and would occupy a highly eccentric orbit that would take it hundreds of astronomical units from the Sun at times. One aspect for the search for Planet 9 is that if it exists, it would be brighter in infrared than it would be in visible light, and that led a team led by Terry Phan, linked to the paper in the description below, to search two archives of infrared all-sky surveys in hopes of spotting Planet 9. And they have a candidate. The first survey was done by IRAS, the Infrared Astronomy Satellite, in 1983, which surveyed for almost a year before finishing its mission. The second survey was the AKARI satellite, launched by the Japanese Aerospace Exploration Agency, or JAXA, that surveyed between 2006 and 2011. The researchers looked first at IRAS and then compared that with AKARI looking for movement. You look at two photographs of the same spot in the sky, and if one of the dots moves, you may have found a planet. This was how Pluto was discovered, in fact. Here they found a dot that appeared to move consistent with what might be expected from the very slow orbiting of Planet 9, which in this case the candidate would be about 700 AU from Earth and would be larger than Neptune. In the two decades between the surveys, the object barely moved, but it did indeed move. The team had to account for parallax, which is where the perspective we see an object changes slightly as Earth orbits the Sun. You can see this effect by holding up a finger and looking at it first with one eye open and then with the other eye, and the finger appears to move. That's parallax. This would also affect an astronomical object like Planet 9. The team removed the effect of that, and the movement was still evident. This looks like a planet. They also removed any fast-moving objects, as a planet in a distant orbit would not be a fast-moving object from our perspective. The candidate appeared as just a dot that was in one position in one dataset, and in another position in the other, and the separation was within the range of Planet 9's expected motion in its orbit. Unfortunately, the data points are not yet enough to determine the full orbit of the object. More data is needed. But the good news is that current large optical telescopes can be used to observe the object in more depth. Because the object is in motion, further observations are best done with instruments with a wide field of view, such as the Dark Energy Camera on the 4-meter Blanco telescope in Chile. One interesting aspect is that most scientists were expecting Planet 9 to be a super-Earth, or even the core of a gas giant, whereas this object would be more like a full-on ice giant, like Neptune, but larger. But not a gas giant the size of Saturn or Jupiter, because NASA's Wide Field Survey Explorer ruled out the possibility of something that large out to about 256,000 AU, and a Saturn-sized object out to about 10,000 AU, but it could not rule out anything much smaller than that. The reason a wide field is needed here is because we don't yet know the orbit of this object, and thus aren't completely certain where it currently is. One of the main aspects of Planet 9 is that if it exists, it probably formed closer to the Sun in the solar system, and then migrated outward into an elliptical orbit, perhaps forming somewhere where the outer major planets currently are. Another possibility is that it's a captured rogue planet from somewhere else in the galaxy, though that's a bit more difficult of a proposition physically. Oddly, this isn't the only time Planet 9 was spotted. There was a false alarm in 2021 when astronomers found another object like this in the IRAS dataset, but no one was able to confirm it, and was not able to confirm it with AKARI. It's probably not there, but this new object is from two datasets, meaning that it is much more likely to actually be out there. Future telescopes like the Nancy Grace Roman Telescope and the Vera Rubin Observatory will allow for more sky surveys that will aid in the search for Planet 9. But with this candidate, there is a problem. It may be in the wrong place to be Planet 9. And if it is in the wrong place, then what exactly is it? In short, this may actually be a new unpredicted planet of some type. The problem is that the suspicion that Planet 9 exists is based on orbital anomalies in the outer solar system. But this infrared signal doesn't quite fit the predictions and isn't responsible for the anomalies. Indeed, this object, as noted by Dr. Brown, would be tilted 120 degrees out of the plane of the solar system. This is different from eccentricity in some ways, and that usually means a highly elliptical orbit, perhaps extremely so in this case. But this one is not just that, but tilted out of the planes that the rest of the planets orbit within. The predictions for Planet 9 were no more than 20 degrees out of this plane, where this new detection is way more pronounced than that. This leaves little room for it to actually be the predicted Planet 9, but in fact, something else. In short, this might actually be Planet 10, or it is 9, if the predicted Planet 9 is wrong. There are still open questions and debates about the inclinations of the Kuiper Belt objects that predict Planet 9. This is all early in the game still, without the proper astronomical equipment needed to look at this. But then there is the pesky issue of gravity. Brown noted in media reports that if there are two planets of this size out there, they couldn't coexist without making each other's orbit unstable. That allows for this detection to actually knock Planet 9 out, and thereby become Planet 9, because the Brown and Bertigan hypothesis has no detection, whereas this new object does. It's going to require the Vera Rubin Observatory to really sort this out, I suspect. But it's built, and undergoing testing, and is set to commence operations in July. So there will be new information on this whole thing within a matter of months, with any luck, and we'll certainly know more within a year or two. But that's not the only question here. Still lurking in the shadows of the outer solar system is the very weird Kuiper Cliff problem. This is a weird one. At almost exactly 47.8 AU, and to explain that briefly, an AU, or astronomical unit, is a measurement based on Earth's distance from the Sun, and comes out to about 93 million miles. So 47.8 times the orbit of Earth, distant in this case. But at that distance, Kuiper Belt objects dramatically drop off in numbers. It's called a cliff because it's like a knife edge. You see objects right up to it, and then so far we haven't detected very many past it. While it's still unclear if it's the end of the Kuiper Belt objects or if it's a gap, it does require explaining as it should not be arranged that way without something else going on. It's actually against predictions from models that said we really ought to see an increase of objects out there instead of a gap. There have been a few explanations advanced, such as material that far out was too scarce to accrete into Kuiper Belt minor planets and objects, but that marked cutoff doesn't seem to support that. But one idea is that the Kuiper Belt is being shepherded, not unlike Saturn's rings, by an unseen planet, somewhere between the size of Mars and Earth hiding out there. No evidence other than the Kuiper Cliff has come to light for this hypothesized planet, but in some ways it is the simplest answer. But a small planet like that will be very difficult to track down and detect, but it certainly is possible. We detect much smaller Kuiper Belt objects regularly, just by chance. That comes down to three unknown planets that may be in the outer solar system. None of the three would be minor planets. They would be large members of the solar system on level with the rest of the planets. To speculate a little, I think the most interesting outcome here would be if this object is indeed a planet. It turns out to be the size of Earth. Earth and Venus are about the same size in the same system, and nothing says a small rocky world can't end up in the outer solar system. Indeed, it would be even more interesting if it turns out to be a captured rogue planet. But the dynamics of the Sun catching a planet out there is a very low likelihood. But it would be fun on several counts since Earth-sized objects tend to have warm interiors due to radioactive decay, as Earth does, if they're not too horribly old. And who knows about things like subsurface oceans on such a world. But also captured Earth-like exoplanet might have once had life. Anyway, the saga of Planet 9 continues. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently eyeing the outer solar system suspiciously. It's very difficult to see objects that far out, something the Vera Rubin Observatory will make significantly easier. But there's just so much out there that we still haven't seen that the potential for new minor and even major planets remains largely wide open. Interesting years ahead, And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channels for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.